And my name is Aaron Karp, and now I'll be walking you through changes that we're making to campaign targeting in V2011.09. So first I'm going to talk about the difference between V2011.09 and V2011.01. I'm going to show you guys some examples of what it looks like in the old version and what it looks like in the new version. And then I'm going to discuss a couple of helper services that we're also releasing that make it easier to get the different campaign target types back from the API so you don't have to rely on the tables and the documentation. Similarly to how we were talking about report fields being available by API service, now many of the geo targets, for example, are available by API service as well. Here's how things looked in V2011.01. At the campaign level, within the settings property, you had geo target type, real-time bidding settings. You had these network settings about Google Search, Google Search Network, Content Network, Content Contextual, Partner Search Network, that sort of thing. Within the campaign target service, you have the ad schedule target, language target, platform target, mobile target, geo target, and demographic target. Here's what's happening in V2011.09. So all that's left in the campaign target service is the ad schedule target. Language target, platform target, mobile target, geo target, demographic target, all gone. Where did they go? To the campaign criterion service. What we're doing is we are starting to treat all of these different targeting parameters the same way that we treat keywords and placements as just another way of determining who sees your ad. Just like the keyword search term helps identify a person to show your ad to, same thing with gender or age range or mobile operating system. Right? Those are all criteria that determine whether or not someone is a good candidate to see your ad and possibly click through. So here's a quick mapping. Looking at the way things were previously, the ad schedule target, the country target, mobile platform target, we've moved them into this criteria categorization. For the most part, it's a one-to-one mapping with the exception of geo-targeting, where you can see city, country, metro, province, etc., all get moved into the same location criterion type. In the process of moving our targeting types into the campaign criterion service, we needed to have criterion IDs for all of these new targeting types. So looking at platform targets, for example, we have these three platform targeting criteria: desktop, high-end mobile, and tablet. What you'll notice is interesting is that they have unique static criteria ID values because there's only one row in our criteria table representing each of those platform target types. So let's look at a response from the campaign target service in V2011.01. If you did a campaign target service.get in the previous version and you were looking at the language targets, you might see what we have at the top here. Target type is language target, language code is English. In V2011.09, we're going to do campaign criterion service.get, and we're going to get back an array of criteria objects. Here we have criterion XSI type is language. It has that ID of 1000, which you'll remember from the previous slide identifies it as English. We also have the code here, EN, for the language, and some other data to help you out. Note that when you send this XML to the API in order to create a new criterion, you don't actually have to send the vast majority of these fields. All you really have to send is the XSI type and the ID. Let's look at one more example, this time with geotargeting. In the previous version of the API, you would receive the following target for a province target. Target type, province target, province code, US, Alabama. In the new campaign criterion service, response, you'll get the following. XSI type is location, the ID is 21133, and the rest of it is helpful data that you might want to have in your response, but doesn't necessarily need to be passed in by you when you actually create one of these criteria. You'll also notice that the response contains a parent locations object, or parent location elements in the XML here, and that shows that the parent of Alabama is 2840, which corresponds to the United States. Let's look at the constant data service, which, as you might imagine, returns data on various constants. Right now it has two methods, one of which is getLanguageCriterion, and that's going to return an array of all the different possible language criteria that you might want to target. here's a snippet of the response. First, we have our English language target, ID 1000. We have our German language target, ID 1001, French 1002, etc. Okay? So you can use this instead of hard coding languages and IDs into your application. If you wanted to refresh this periodically or even do it on the fly, you have the option of pulling an up-to-the-date list that matches exactly what we have in AdWords using the service. We also have another new service called the Location Criterion Service. This one is kind of like a search service for matching different geographic terms with the corresponding AdWords objects. In this example here, I'm going to be searching for a location using our nice generic selector format. I'm going to pass in a predicate to search for where the location name equals this set of Chinese characters. This also serves to show how the service works cross-language. Okay, so what does the response look like for this search? Those Chinese characters correspond to Beijing, the city of Beijing in China. So we get back our criterion type is a location where the name is Beijing, display type city, and it also gives us back the parents. So we can tell from this that the city of Beijing is within the region of Beijing, which is within the country of China, and we can get back the canonical name as well right here, which is Google canonical localized representation of Beijing in this case. All right, let's look at a little bit of a code example. How would one actually create one of these new campaign criteria? In this case, we're gonna create a tablet target, and we're going to create a geo target for the country of Mexico using PHP in this particular case. So we create our new platform target object. We set its ID. Now again, you can pull that from your database, you can pull that from our constant data service, or you can just have it hard-coded in as well. We're gonna create a new campaign criterion object using this ID, pretty simple. Then we're gonna do the same exact thing with the country targets. A new location object, we're going to create a campaign criterion object that encloses that location. We're gonna add it to our array of campaign criteria. And then below is what you guys are already familiar with, basically setting the operator as add and sending it to the campaign criterion service with the mutate method. So where can you find these IDs? Well, a couple of them are available in the constant data service. But for everything else, we have published lists of codes down at the very bottom left of the documentation page. Under system codes, you can see here I have the age ranges selected. So these are the different criterion IDs for all these possible age range targets. All right, thank you very much.